see about how to retrieve the data from series object. So after creating the series object, we can assess its indexes separately, and through that indexes. So first one is how to assess the integer element through index. The index should be covered by a square bracket, enclosed by square bracket. The general form for assessing the integer element is series object name and square bracket, and you should give the valid index name. So valid indexes means totally the series objects contain 5 element, but we give that 7th index means is wrong, so you should give the valid index. And in series object, if there is any duplicate indexes means it will not raise any problem. It will return that both entries. We see the example. So here object 1 is a series object, and there are 4 elements, 10, 20, 30, and not a number. So first we are printing that object 1, and object 1 of 2 means it is the second position. Actually, position start from 0, 0th position 10, and first position 20, and second position is 30. So 30 is printed, and object 1 of 3, third position value is not a number, so it's also printed. So in that first example, index label is not given, so by default value 0, 1, 2, 3 is assigned for index. And next we are assigning that index A, B, C, A for that object 1 series data. So printed first, and object 1 of C label, so C label corresponding value 78.6 is printed, and object 1 of A, here there are 2 A indexes, so both data are displayed. So we already seen the object has duplicate indexes means both will be displayed, both also will be written entries along with the index. So in this example we have to see at a time we can assess that more than one indexes. If you want to assess more than one indexes means the indexes should be closed with a double square bracket. So first that created a series objects printed, and next statement print object 1 of double square bracket C comma B. So here both indexes going to assess C and B. So more than one and indexes you want to assess mean you should enclose the indexes by double square bracket. And in dictionary, how we can assess through the keys. See, series object is created from data created from dictionary. So three keys and value pairs there: January, February, and March. So we are going to assess the January key data. So we should give object 1 of square bracket the key value January, so 31 is displayed. And next slicing is nothing but it retrieve the subset of data from a pentest object. So how we can slice the data from series object, this is general format: series object name, square bracket, start, end, and step. Always end and step value we have to subtract -1 in the given value. So see here, object 1 of 1 is the start value, and 4 is the end value. That means 4 minus 1, 3 is the end value, ending position. And 2 is the step value, that is 2 minus 1 is 1 is the step value. And 1 value we have to skip from the start position. So according to the position, the value is display. So here what will be? Starting position is 1. So 1, 2, we are going to assess the element third position, ending position. In that gap, we have to skip one known value. So B is a starting value printed, and skipping value is C, and the next A value, A position value will be printed. So result is 70.5 and 89.8. And I say another example here. Here the starting value alone given 2 colon. Ending value is not given. So till the last element, it is retrieved. So second position means C. So C to till the end data are retrieved. And this example, starting value is not given, ending value is given. Ending value is 3, so 3 minus 1, 2 is the end value. So if the starting value is not given, means default will start from 0th position. So 0 to second position's value. 0th position means that A label to C label values are retrieved and displayed. And this example, 0 colon 2 is given, that is starting position 0, ending position 2 minus 1, 1. So only 0 to 1, the two data is all retrieved. And then here, starting value is minus 3, that is a backward indexing is given. Backward indexing position start from minus 1 in a series object. So starting minus 3 and ending values are 5 minus 1, 4. So starting minus 3 2 and then ending value 4. The data is all retrieved. So answer 78.6, 89.8 and 90 is displayed. And the next turn, starting position is minus 5, ending value is 5 minus 1, 4, and skipping value 1, 2 minus 1, that's the step value 1. So, see the table. So, minus 5 position and was 56.6, and skip 1 value, then we get minus 3 position 78.6, and next minus 1 position 90 value are printed. And the next, we are giving, there is no start value, stop value, only step value, that's also minus 1. So it's printing the elements in the reverse order. The next one, start value is 0, end value is not given, and step value is 3 minus 1, 2. So from the starting 2 to value skip and printing till the end of the series object data. So first is 0th position 56.6 and skip the two values, and then 89.8 value is printed. And likewise minus 4's starting position and skipping value is 2. There is no end, so to the end it will be printed. So minus 4 2 and then fourth position 70.5 and next skip the two values, then 90 is printed. And three more methods are used for retrieving the data from the series object. LOC method, we can get the rows or columns with a particular label from the index. Through the labels we can assess the set of elements. And ILOC means through the position, integer value, takes integer value, to the position we can retrieve the rows and columns from the series object. And IX is work as like both LOC and ILOC. If there is no index means it will work like a LOC, always useful like a ILOC. So general format for LOC is series object dot LOC. We should give the start label name and end label name. So when we use LOC method, we must give the label in the series object. And ILOC general format is series object dot ILOC start row position and colon end row position. So see the example, data is given and index of the data A, B, C, D, E. So here LOC A colon C. So label is mentioned, A label to and C label, data are retrieved. So here till the end, LOC means the last value also include A to C label values are displayed. And ILOC, here starting position is 1 and ending is 3. So if you 3 minus 1, 2. So it will retrieve only the first row and second row alone. See, ILOC does not include the last value mentioned in the square bracket, but LOC it's include the last value. That is the main difference between LOC and ILOC. And say here, ILOC 1 colon 3 is given, and here index is not given. Index label is not given for this series object. If it's not given, means by default value 0, 1, 2, like that order will be taken. So from that 1 position 70.5 and 3 minus 1 in position 2 is a, not a number is displayed. And then next one, LOC, here also index is not given, even though it's not given, okay. It will take the index value default 0, 1, 2, 3 and LOC include the last value. So start value 1 and end value with the third position values are retrieved. So ILOC does not include the last value mentioned in that square bracket instead last, but LOC include the last value. IX of 1 colon 3 is given. So here index is not given. So it will take 1 to 3 values will be retrieved and displayed. And here label is given. And here IX 1 colon 3, but it will retry 1 to 2. So if label is given, means it will work like a ILOC. You can retrieve the set of data using head and tail functions. Head means it retrieve the first n elements and tail means retrieve the last n element. General format for head function is series object dot head of n. Here n means the number of elements to be retrieved. Likewise, tail functions in general form is series object name dot tail of n. So n is the number of elements to be retrieved from the series object. So see here, and head of 3 is given. So first 3 elements of a series objects is retrieved. And tail of 3 means the last 3 elements of series objects are retrieved. And if there is no n value in the head and tail function, means default value is 5. So first 5 value will be retrieved from the series object. So here object 1 is printed and object 1 dot tail of empty is given. There is no n value. So first 5 values will be retrieved. Sorry, tail function. So it will retrieve the last 5 values. And next object 1 dot head empty is given. So here head means first the 5 values is retrieved. Functions used for retrieving the data. That is a take functions. As a take means just take the positions value given in the square bracket. So it will take that 2, 4, 5. So second, fourth, fifth position value will be retrieved from the series object.